Hi everyone, and welcome to my YouTube channel. And my name is Jennifer, and this is the monthly tarot reading for the Earth signs for April 2021. And the Earth signs are Taurus, Virgo, and Capricorn. And as always, this is a general reading, so take what you can and leave the rest. And if you would like a private reading that will be geared more towards what's going on in your life, then you can visit my website at jenniferrowanpsychicmedium.com and you will see many options of readings to choose from. And now let's move on to your reading and see what is going to come up with you this month. Now I have pulled some oracle cards and I'm using the Angels of Atlantis card and also the cards Beyond Lemuria cards. And then we will move forward with the tarot cards. And so the first card that we have is Archangel Michael. And this is concerning patience. And so the message that Archangel Michael is bringing is that he is indicating you've been rushing to create things in your life or to manifest something. And this is a time to work to allow things to happen instead of pushing things to happen. And this is going to help you to see patience between what you visualize and what actually manifests. And one thing that you can do is to meditate and be still so that you can consider your desire without attachment. Then this will allow you to see what may happen or what comes to you. And the next card that we have is Mount Shasta. And if you look at this card, you can see above the mountain, there are lots of lights and energy. And actually, Mount Shasta is actually a mountain or a volcano that's in California. And this is a place that the Lemurian people or star beings journeyed. And also you will hear of stories of multidimensional beings living inside the mountains and sightings of unusual phenomena. And so what this card is telling you is it's time to honor and look deeply into your ancestry, both your bloodline and etheric lineage, because you may have an affinity with star beings. Connecting with them can give you a lot of insight into your traits, strengths, and challenges. Also, visit any sacred places that you feel attracted to. There may be some intuitive messages for you at some of these places. And I always say, go where you feel like you're guided to go, because we're always attracted to it for some reason. And you aren't going to know until you actually take that step. And now let's move on to the tarot cards and see what this month has in store for you. And the first card that we have, which is the overall energy, and this is the Eight of Wands. And this is showing me that you may have had some delays recently with things going on in your life or even opportunities. And so this card is showing me that there are going to be end of delays or slow periods. And also sometimes with this card, there will be news that's coming your way. This is a card about forward movement and things picking up. So you're going to find that you're going to be very busy on and off throughout the month. And sometimes you might feel like it's difficult to keep up, but I feel like you're going to enjoy this because of the things that are happening around you. Also, this can show me that things may be going in a new direction for you, that this is going to be a period of opportunities and growth, and that your hard work is paying off. Also, this can be a time of air travel or taking some type of short-term trip and a trip that may have been unexpected. This could be for business or it could be for personal reasons. Remember that when you see this card, it's good to go with the flow because again, things are going to be picking up and very busy. And so just take one thing at a time and see what comes to you. So this is going to be good this month, especially for some of you where you have felt that business has been slow or other things in your life have been going very slowly. And for the first week of the month, we have the Four of Pentacles. And if you take a look at this card, this person looks like they're holding on to something and they don't want to let it go. And while it's always great to have income flowing in and saving your money, it's also good not to hold on to it too tightly. This is a card about having financial security and stability in your life. And also, you're going to have this money for your retirement as well. But sometimes you may be too concerned with your finances and you're afraid to go out and spend it because you're afraid that you don't have enough. And that's not the case. Also, you don't want to put money in front of everything all the time. You also want to go out and have fun and make sure, again, that you're letting things flow. Find that healthy balance between saving and spending. And when we see the Pentacles, this is about stability and security. So just again, go out and have fun and enjoy, but just don't, I say, hoard. And the next card that we have, which is about, which is around the second week of the month, and this is the Three of Pentacles. And if you take a look at this card, there are three people and they're all working together. They're all doing something different. They're being creative. And this is going to bring goals coming to you. And also it's going to be bringing financial increase to you as well. And again, this card is about teamwork. And this is going to bring more business to you. It also shows me that all of you are going to be committed and dedicated to your work as well. And each person contributes their skills and their knowledge to this project or this goal. And by doing this, this is going to give you good results. And it also gives a better chance of success happening. All of you have the skills and resources to accomplish your objectives. And if you keep doing this and you keep working on it, you're going to see progress and you're going to see that your goal or objective moves forward. And as we get to about the third week of the month, we have the Two of Wands. And if you look at this person, she's looking out the window and basically daydreaming about her future. And this can be a male or a female. And so I feel that you will have the energy and the courage to do this and accomplish this. And also what this is showing me, this can be a time of partnerships. So whatever it is that you want to start, whether it's a new project or a new business, that you may get involved with somebody else. And also, this is about setting your intention and setting your goals so that you can have a good outcome. At this point, things are still in a new phase, but you can create something good that will expand if you commit yourself and dedicate yourself to this. Also, you need to think about your long-term goals and also have the courage to try something new. So there may be something new that's going to be coming to you, or maybe you just came up with an idea and you're kicking this around, but you're not sure that you have the confidence to do this. Well, the only way you're going to know if this works for you is if you actually try it, and it may turn out a lot better than what you expected. Now, also, this could be someone who is thinking about going back to school. So you may be taking some type of classes to further your skills. And also, this could be a time where you're thinking about switching careers. So maybe there's been something that you've been doing for a long time and now you want to either totally switch your career or you want to add something to it so that you have a new skill and that will even bring more success to you. So far this month, everything looks great. And as we get to about the fourth week of the month, we have the Ten of Cups. And if you look at this card, this is showing me that there's a happy couple and they're just looking at everything around them. The kids are playing in the yard. Everybody looks happy. Everybody has a lot of joy. And also there's a lot of abundance there. And this is always a good card to get because this tells me, first of all, if you've been going through some difficulties either throughout the month or maybe in the months previous to this, it's saying that there's going to be happiness and harmony in all of your relationships. This could be in your home, which is family. This could be in a relationship. And also it could be work related as well. So everybody's getting along. There aren't any disagreements or conflict going on. And also on another note, this can be a time of celebration or even celebrating a holiday. And we do have Easter coming up this month as well. It's also showing me that everything is in perfect alignment because you've been working very hard to see what you've created happening. And also there may be some good opportunities that either recently came your way or will be coming your way that's going to bring abundance to you. So that's what I have for you this month, Earth Signs. I think it's going to be a great month for you. I think you're going to be moving along really quickly. But that's a good thing if things have been stagnant. And also all your hard work and efforts is going to pay off either this month or in the near future. Now I have a lottery number for you and it is 313. And as always, I want to thank everyone for visiting my channel, whether you are new to the channel or you have been visiting my channel over the past year. I greatly appreciate it. Please feel free to like, share, and subscribe, and hit that notification bell, and that will alert you when new videos become available. So thank you, Earth Signs. I hope you have a great month of April, and also I wish you a happy Easter.